Meanwhile, more than 90% in crime complaints during the MCO. Joining us live from Kuala Lumpur is Gail Aldos. Hello, Gail.
Here's the latest news in Malaysia. More than 90% jump in cybercrime complaints during MCO. Some 2,906 complaints were lodged to the Cyber 9999 Help Center during the Movement Control Order MCO period from March 18 to June 30th, an increase of more than 90% compared to the same period last year. Deputy Communications and Multimedia Minister Datuk Zahidi Zainal Abidin said the reported cases involved cyberbullying, fraud, intrusion, hacking attempt, and spam, which mostly occurred in urban areas with a high-speed internet connection. Zahidi told a press conference that they had received various complaints with multiple types of modus operandi that included packages from agents who claimed they represented telco companies after receiving telecommunications users' complaints and cybercrime memorandum from the Muslim Consumers Association of Malaysia, PPIM. The Cyber 999 Help Center is operated by the Malaysia Computer Emergency Response Team, MICERT, under the Cybersecurity Malaysia, which provides emergency response on computer security-related matters such as cyber harassment, malware, intrusion, hack attempts, and other information security breaches. Zahidi said there were offers which promised a variety of free services, but in a few months, the customers' bills spiked to 5,000 ringgit. He said that most of the victims were students, and some were even blacklisted for not being able to pay the bill. Among other cyber fraud incidents were misuse of personal data, online scam, and soft loan scam, he added. Zahidi stressed that the government viewed seriously cybercrime issues such as online scam and gambling. He also said that discussions between the Malaysian Communications and Multimedia Commission, Cybersecurity Malaysia, and private entities had been held to allow them to carry out their duties accordingly in the fight against cybercrime. In other news, Malaysia will continue to support the Palestinian struggle. Prime Minister Tan Sri Muhyiddin Yassin said in a posting on Facebook yesterday that Malaysia will continue to give its support to the struggle of the Palestinians and has called on the world community, especially the United Nations, UN, to immediately find the best solution to the controversial peace plan in the region. Accompanying the posting were four pictures of the Prime Minister receiving a courtesy call from My Aqsa Foundation's delegation, led by its founder and chairman, Suwardi Yaqub, at his office yesterday. Muhyiddin said during the meeting, which lasted almost an hour, he was also briefed about the foundation, which was established in 2017. The Prime Minister was proud of the commitment and continuous efforts taken by the My Aqsa in educating the people about the Israel-Palestine conflict and the importance of Al-Aqsa Mosque, which is one of the three mosques valued above all others in Islam, after that of Masjid al-Haram, Grand Mosque, and the Nabawi Mosque. Muhyiddin also shared that the delegation also explained to him of My Aqsa's involvement at the international level, especially in the case of the Israeli war crimes against Palestine in the International Criminal Court, ICC, and the violation of UN Security Council Resolution 2334. He said Malaysia, through My Aqsa, is the only organization from the Asian region which dared to file a protest against Israeli brutality at the ICC. He said that it is his and the My Aqsa's hope to see Malaysia play a bigger role in strengthening the unification of the Palestinians in facing today's challenges. Back to you, Alma.
All right. Thank you very much, Gail, for your updates there. Thank you, EBC Malaysia Bureau.
Thank you. Reporting live from EBC Malaysia Bureau, this is Gail Aldos. We live in interesting times.
All right, and let's get the